Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Thomas Cook has evacuated its 300 customers from an Egyptian hotel amid a food poisoning scare and following the death of a woman who died of grief after her husband was killed by a heart attack. Susan Cooper, 63, and her husband John Cooper, 69, were on a trip of a lifetime at the hotel, which is in the Red Sea resort town of Hurghada, when tragedy struck. Thomas Cook announced in a statement guests had been evacuated from the hotel as a precautionary measure and that there had been reports of a raised level of illness among guests. The firm's announcement comes as scores of people have complained online that they suffered food poisoning when staying at the hotel. Devoted, Susan Cooper, 63, and her husband John Cooper, 69, pictured together, were on holiday at the Steigenberger Aqua Magic Hotel in the Red Sea resort town of Hurghada. One of the tourists was a Thomas Cook employee at the Burnley branch, pictured, of the travel agent trip of a lifetime. The pair were staying at the Steigenberger Aqua Magic Hotel, pictured, in the resort. Thomas Cook has now removed all its 300 customers from the hotel. Thomas Cook's move comes amid a food poisoning scare at the hotel. Thomas Cook said in the statement, "We are deeply saddened by the tragic deaths of two of our customers who were staying in the Steigenberger Aqua Magic Hotel in Hurghada, Egypt. The circumstances of their deaths are still unclear. Safety is always our first priority, so as a precautionary measure we have taken a decision to remove all our customers from this hotel. We will be offering customers alternative hotels within Hurghada, as well as giving them the option to return home. For those customers who choose to come home, we have made the arrangements to fly them back tomorrow, the 24th of August. While we understand this is upsetting for those on holiday, we believe this is the right thing to do. We continue to work closely with the hotel and are supporting the authorities with their investigations." The Steigenberger Aqua Magic Hotel was last audited by Thomas Cook in late July 2018 and received an overall score of 96%. "We will be contacting those customers due to travel to the Steigenberger Aqua Magic Hotel in Hurghada in the next 4 weeks to offer alternative holiday options." Several past guests of the hotel have said online that they have fallen ill since staying there and say the standards are poor at the resort. Daily Thompson tweeted today, "At Thomas Cook, I came back from Aqua Magic last Saturday and have had bad gut since. Do I need to worry after the news that has been released tonight?" Cal Sham said on TripAdvisor in May, "All four of us got ill, vomiting and diarrhea, and ended up in hospital with the children, aged 2.5 and 1. My son was hospitalized again on our return." He added that he saw birds eating at the food, that the bathroom was smelly, and waiters were not friendly towards children. On Facebook, Allison Cope said, "This is the hotel we are in. Thomas Cook are moving all their customers out tomorrow due to an increase in sickness. I wish all the Cooper family love and respect and am I very sorry for the loss. I think the food standards in the hotel have been very poor and the hotel is full of Sir Thomas Cook management due to the very sad deaths. The cause of death hasn't been officially released but they are taking things very seriously." John, who ran his own building company in their hometown of Burnley, Lancashire, had a heart attack and was rushed to hospital where he died on Tuesday. Susan was a long-serving Thomas Cook employee, died of grief just hours later, said Dr. Major Deladawi, the head of Hurghada Hospital. The travel firm said there has been an increased level of illness among guests. Pictured a room in the hotel. Mrs. Cooper, a long-serving Thomas Cook employee, died of grief just hours later after her husband died of a heart attack. Many people have also given the hotel one-star reviews on TripAdvisor in which they said they have fallen ill when they stayed there. Some of the one-star reviews the hotel has received on TripAdvisor: "The loveliest couple, Mrs. Cooper, a long-serving Thomas Cook employee in her hometown of Burnley, died of grief just hours after her husband, pictured together. It is understood Mrs. Cooper died due to low blood pressure which led to her heart stopping. It is thought the low blood pressure was caused by the nervous shock she experienced when her husband passed away. The couple lived in a bungalow and did charity work with the Burnley and Pendle District Freemasons. Their daughter Kelly Ormerod, 40, was on holiday with her parents and is currently at the resort. Heartbroken, Kelly and husband Darren have been escorted by the British Foreign Office." Her neighbor said, "She is beside herself with grief. As soon as she heard the news, she wanted to be there. She is so close to both her parents, particularly her mum, who was her best friend. Our hearts go out to her. We don't know how she'll cope with such a sudden and shocking loss. They are well known and much loved in the community. This is a devastating blow. Mrs. Ormerod lives just a mile away from her parents John and Susan Cooper's luxury home in Burnley, Lancashire, which was lovingly built by her father. He ran a reputable building company, J.J. Cooper, Safe as Houses. A devastated friend told Mail Online, "They were the loveliest couple you could ever wish to meet. They were devoted to each other and couldn't live without each other. Our hearts are breaking. This is such sad news." A neighbor, named as Gillian, described the pair as sociable and popular, adding, "They loved traveling and had been all over. They were the nicest people, warm and welcoming, and always had a smile for you. They were pure gold and you don't find many couples like them. I can't believe they've gone. It is so tragic," another neighbor added. "We've heard the news, and it's heartbreaking. They were a lovely couple. It's a total tragedy and our hearts go out to the family." The Burnley Thomas Cook store where Mrs. Cooper worked was shut today with a sign on the door reading, "Due to unforeseen circumstances this store will be closed." A devastated friend of the couple, pictured, told Mail Online, "They were the loveliest couple you could ever wish to meet." A notice on the door of the Thomas Cook store says, "Due to unforeseen circumstances this store will be closed today." A colleague at a nearby Thomas Cook store said, "We are a close team and we know the member of staff who died. It is heartbreaking and tragic. Mrs. Cooper had gone on a trip of a lifetime and sadly will never come back. The store is closed as a sign of respect. The team there are devastated and closed up shop yesterday." Thomas Cook's head of customer welfare, Carol McKenzie, flew to Hurghada last night to offer support to the couple's families. The company said in a statement, "We are deeply saddened by the deaths of two of our customers while on holiday in Hurghada in Egypt, one of whom was a loyal and long-serving member of our Thomas Cook family. Our focus is on fully supporting the loved ones. We are urgently investigating with the hotel and supporting the local authorities." The Thomas Cook website describes Hurghada, pictured in stock image, as the capital of the Red Sea Riviera. The Thomas Cook website describes Hurghada as the capital of the Red Sea Riviera, where beautiful beaches, vibrant nightclubs and world-class diving destinations await. The company offers all-inclusive holidays to around 20 hotels there. A Foreign Office spokesman said, "We are supporting the family of a British couple who died in Hurghada, Egypt, and we are in contact with a local tour operator. Have you recently stayed at the hotel or are you due to stay at it? Email brendan.mcfadden@mailonline.co.uk. Last year, Hurghada was thrown into chaos when a knifeman killed two German women and injured four tourists on the beach. Police said the assailant swam from a nearby beach before stabbing people while shouting, 'Stay away, I don't want Egyptians.' In January 2016, three foreign tourists were stabbed at the same resort by two suspected ISIS militants.